Yo, what's going on, guys? Dan here, back again. Another video for you guys. Gonna be showing you guys how to nollie heel. I did do a video on this a while back, but it was just like a head cam view. So I'm gonna be doing a more of a like a third person view and head cam view, just to kind of update my last trick tip that I did on this video. This is one of my favorite tricks to do. So hopefully you guys enjoy this. As always, make sure to like, comment, sub to the channel. They greatly help me out. Comment whatever other trick tip you want me to do, so you guys seem like I can help you guys learn and whatnot. But let me just get right into this. Nollie heel is my favorite trick. Let me see if I can do this just like straight flat ground without rolling for you guys real quick though. So that's nollie heel for you guys. Obviously I'm rolling just a little bit because I am on a downhill slope right here where I'm at, but that's nollie heel for you guys. So I guess I'll go ahead and just like show you guys my foot placement from this point of view, so you guys can kind of just see like from a third person how I'm doing it, and then I'm gonna switch over to head cam and show you guys from a POV kind of view on how I set up for the nollie heel. I'll do a few tricks here and there of the nollie heel as well, flat ground and whatnot, but here we go. Well, that's nollie heel for you guys. Again, I can't stress how much I love that trick. I've been doing that for so long, it's pretty much like my go-to trick. That or switch heel. I'll be doing a switch heel video too. If you want to see that, leave a comment in the comment section down below and like the video. Let me know you guys want to see a switch heel tutorial. But for now, nollie heel. Now let me show you guys my foot placement just so you guys can get an understanding as to my personal favorite set up for a nollie heel, because we all set up differently. So obviously, if this isn't for you, try a different setup. You know, you might like some other YouTuber setup, you might like your homie setup, you might like my setup, who knows. But you're gonna have to set up however it is that you feel comfortable to do this trick. Hopefully my setup does help you guys, because I think I'm doing it pretty stable, like where my foot placement is and whatnot. But let me just show you guys that real quick, and then we'll move over to head cam. All right guys, so when setting up for a nollie heel, obviously you're gonna wanna learn how to nollie first. That's obviously the first trick you're gonna wanna learn to do. But this is my nollie heel setup. So again, I'm gonna try not to roll out of like camera angle, but so I'm gonna put my back foot right here behind the bolts. Hopefully you guys can see that. And pretty much like my whole like middle section of my foot is on there. Like a little bit of my toes are hanging off and a little bit of my heels are hanging off. For the most part, my whole foot's on the back part of my board, just behind the bolts. And the front foot's gonna go right here in the middle of the nose, kind of like you're gonna nollie. So this is how my setup's gonna be right here, guys, just like that. So you guys can see the ball. If you guys don't know what the ball of your foot is, it's this part right here. So the ball of my foot is going directly on the middle of the nose, like this, and my back foot's right there behind the bolts. Now all you're gonna do is pop. So you're gonna pop, and then with this foot, don't kick down, don't kick straight out. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna roll your ankle and kick your heel out. Kick your heel up and out in a diagonal way. So you're kicking out of the tail. So you're doing an ollie heel flip. But let me show you guys that real quick. So it's okay if you don't land it first try, second try, fifth try, whatever. That's just to show you guys how it looks. Most of us are gonna learn that way. Like as far as like, oh, you know, we're gonna flip the board and not land on it. It's completely okay, don't worry about it. Just keep practicing. But this is how it's gonna look. So that's essentially what it'll look once you get it down. At first, you know, you might get it a little ugly. It's okay, keep practicing your trick. It'll get better, it's gonna look a lot nicer. And you might be able to get some letters on your homies in a game of skate. Who knows? But that's how you set up, guys. I guess I can give you guys like another quick little tip. All right, so one helpful tip that I do have for you guys is just like I said in the kickflip tutorial video, which I'll put up in the link description right up here. And so in the kickflip tutorial, I said you can land the trick with your front foot or you can land it with your back foot. That's specifically for a kickflip though, when I did that trick, because you can't land it with your front foot and you can't land it with your back foot. Now for a nollie heel though, what I've discovered is that when you're practicing it, you can only land it with your back foot. If you don't want to like completely commit to it, you have to land it with your back foot. I'll show you guys like this, watch. So that's one way to help you guys like conquer nollie heels a lot faster, is getting your back foot back onto the board and landing it that way. I would suggest doing that just so you can kind of get a feel for it and be comfortable bringing that back foot in, because your front foot, whether it be this foot or this foot that you're nollieing with, whether you be regular or goofy, make sure to use your back foot as kind of like a starting point to bring that foot back in and land on the board, because the front foot, which you're nollieing with, is gonna have to stay over that board. And you're gonna have to commit. That's the only way to bring that foot back onto the board. You have to commit, and that leg's gonna come back, gonna stay over the board, and you're gonna have to stop your trick. So I'll show you guys. I'm not gonna lie, my legs are a little tired right now, but as you guys saw, I brought this foot back in. This foot stayed over the board. But let's switch over to head cam real quick. Show you guys some more of my foot placement, a little bit of a better view, and then we'll end the video there, guys. All right, guys, so like I said, we're gonna be doing the POV version now. Show you guys my foot placement while I'm standing still, while I'm rolling, and just to show you guys how it looks from POV, whatever, head cam point of view. So again, stand in front of your board. If you're regular, if you're goofy, hopefully this helps for both of you guys, but put your back foot behind the bolts where you guys can see right there. Again, a little bit of my foot is hanging off, a little bit of my heel is hanging off, but for the most part, the middle part of my foot is directly on the board behind those bolts. Now, your front foot, the one that you nollie with, right there, bam. Ball of your foot right in the middle of the nose, literally right in the middle of the nose, towards kind of the tip of the nose, not too far up to the top, not too far back, kind of right in the center. And then what you're gonna do, again, is you wanna nollie, so you're gonna pop your nose, and with the back foot you're gonna want to roll your ankle, slide up and out in a diagonal version, so you're pretty much kicking off the tail. I don't know if you guys can see the little bit of white right here, but that's from my heel. So again, this is my setup: ball of my foot on the nose, back foot behind the bolts. Again, pretty much your whole middle section of your foot is on your board. Pop and flick. So you guys can see right there, this is what I mean about putting your back foot back onto the board, is that's a good, like, I guess that's a good, like, little, I guess, training or feel for how it is that your back foot's gonna come onto your board. And it also just builds confidence, so we'll do it again. So you guys can see right there, see how the back foot's coming off? That's okay, you wanna practice with your back foot, because your back foot's the important thing to bring back into the board, because that's the foot that's leaving the board, and you have to bring it back in. This foot is gonna stay over the board, but you have to commit to leaving it over the board. If not, you're gonna land just like this, how I did right now, with your back foot on the board and your front foot back here. But anyways, again, back foot, middle section of your back foot behind the bolts, ball of your foot on the nose, pop, kick, and flick. And that's nollie heel. So again, just practice getting your back foot on there. It'll really, really help you guys. And then just commit to bringing this foot, like, having this foot stay over the board instead of landing like this. First get comfortable landing your back foot back onto the board. Once you're comfortable doing that, start committing to keeping this foot over the board. Right? I said bring this foot back to the board. Yeah. So bring this foot back to the board, and then commit to keeping this foot over the board, so that way you land the nollie heel, so you get this. Nollie heel, guys. So I'll do it a few more times just so you guys can see my foot placement while I'm rolling, and how it looks while I'm actually rolling and actually doing the trick. Because doing the trick completely standing still is completely different than when you're rolling. And that's just something that's another video I guess I'll leave for another day. But so here we go, another nollie heel while rolling. Woo! Pretty satisfying though when you can do it like at a pretty decent speed and while rolling. It just makes you feel like you have that trick on lock and just gives you better confidence on that trick. But anyways, that's about it for this one, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment in the comment section down below. Let me know what other videos you guys want me to do. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Keep on skating, guys, and again, thank you. Hope this helped.